Can you hear it?
Yeah.
Sirens, screams, crashes. Can you see it? Perception, visibility, focus. Can you feel it? Uncertainty, uneasiness, unawareness. There seems to be a feeling in this nation, a sense that all is not right.
Mm-mm.
And everywhere we see those who do not understand it, they do not see it, and red flags are coming up everywhere in everything we do, every place we go, to those of us who have the eyes and the ears and the feeling to see it. The blame game is played out every day. Decisions are made in a positive direction by those who see, and they are called misguided by the one who doesn't have a clue, representing many others who are clueless. How can you have an answer if you don't even know the question?
Mm-hmm.
To me, if you're in charge, if you are an elected representative, if you're the governor of this state, then you have to have an idea of what's going on and an idea of how to fix it. But so many people on the national level, they just want the glory. And I do not care about that. I'm not a career politician. Never have been, don't plan on being. But I am as concerned about our nation as our state as every one of you that are here today. Someone asked me the other day, said, what do you think about President Obama? I said, he is Nancy Pelosi in a suit.
Yeah.
Neither one seemed to have a clue or how to fix it. They just want to show how important they are by carrying the big gavel down the halls of Congress so that you can see what they look like and who they are, and look at me, aren't we great? And our country is going down the tubes while they do it.
Yeah.
And I'm here to tell you we're going to stop it. We're going to change it. Right here in our own state.
Hurry up.
The department. Thank you, ma'am. July 27th, you'll have that opportunity to get me there. The Department of Human Services is a $1.9 billion entity of this state government. Started out with great things in mind, helping people who had sickness and children that they couldn't care for themselves. And now it's grown to an agency that is just overwhelmed by those with their hands out. I was talking to someone outside a while ago, and I said, you know, I don't mind any of you stopping by and having dinner with me, or I'll take you out to dinner. But I've got more people at my dinner table now than I think I can afford. It is difficult. 60% of Oklahomans now are on some form of welfare. One third. A little bit more. 42% of the mothers in Oklahoma last year were single mothers. 60% of those, you and I, paid for them to have a baby. When we had our kids, we paid for it.
Mm-hmm.
We didn't expect anybody else to pay for it. We paid for it. But everybody is standing with their hand out. Women can have 4, 5, and 6 kids, documented, Department of Human Services, their own drugs. What happens? You get to send them out, collect another check. I will call it felony child abuse. You have one baby on drugs in Oklahoma, you're going to jail. We're going to take that baby, we're going to have to anyway.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But we're going to make a difference. We're going to get some of those women some help that have been abused growing up, who've had difficult situations, and get them cared for and treated. The Department of Corrections. You know, we recruit for OU football. We go, oh, we've got to have the best players. And they just had a great draft. You know, a lot of our kids are going to make millions of dollars. OSU, they go out and recruit. Every local school, every local college. Get the best players you can. And what do we do in Oklahoma? Nothing. I'm for going to Arizona and recruiting Sheriff Joe.
Yeah!
Guy asked me the other day, if I had a knew anything about a gun. I said I've had one ever since I was big enough to tote it, know how to use it, and will. Thanks for your time.